Currently scheduled for a Monday morning launch from the Kennedy Space Center. This will be the first SpaceX Falcon Heavy launch in 3 years.
Westview Scott Hyler's live for us now from KSC. And Scott, how are things looking?
Right now, they're looking good. You know, the rocket now is standing upright on launch pad 39A. That happened overnight. And at some point today, we're expecting a static test fire. Once that happens, the world's most powerful rocket will then be taken off the pad so that two classified U.S. Space Force satellites can be loaded. Essentially, the Falcon Heavy is three Falcon 9 rockets strapped together. Two of the boosters will return to Earth in an amazing scene of simultaneous landings. The third booster will place the satellites in a distant orbit. In all, 28 Merlin engines will fire. It'll be the first Falcon Heavy launch since 2019.
Yeah, the primary reason the Falcon Heavy has basically stayed on the sidelines for 3 years is that the payloads that were supposed to fly on it just weren't ready.
And those big payloads are from NASA and the DOD. Eric Berger wrote a book on Elon Musk and SpaceX.
I think symbolically, it's a really important rocket for SpaceX because, first of all, it showed that a private company could build the world's largest, most powerful rocket. I mean, think about that. Before that, it was entirely government-funded projects.
And right now, the Falcon Heavy is the only rocket that can hit all the orbits that the DOD wants to get to. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Hyler, West 2 News.